this gun. Hacksmith, it is excellent, just like the one I ripped off the tank.
Hey guys, in case you haven't been following us on Instagram or Facebook, we've just finished building Zarya's particle cannon from the game Overwatch. It's real and it works. Now in case you haven't caught them, we already did two videos on this project showing the design. You can click it there or in the description below to catch up on those episodes. But the gun is done now and it is awesome. It worked out way better than we thought it would. So without further ado, enjoy.
So the gun is mostly assembled now, and we're about to give it its very first test.
What happened to this power switch? Do you remember?
It's not gonna fit, Bogdan.
It's gonna fit.
All right, the pump is running. You can see bubbles going.
Plasma globe is not plasmaing. Okay, let's turn this on.
We can smell ozone right now, which means the plasma globe is arcing inside.
Okay, ready?
Okay. All right, it's finally finished, and Bogdan has done an absolutely amazing job on this project. In fact, this is our highest value completed Make It Real project we've ever done. The 3D printer filament alone was worth thousands of dollars, and so was the laser equipment, not to mention 3 months of Bogdan's time, and he is a paid employee here. But enough on that, let's go test it. All right, so let's test this for the first time. Now, just to remind you, this is not a prop. Inside is an 80-watt CO2 laser tube, which produces an infrared laser. It's the same laser tube used in my CNC laser cutter, which is capable of cutting up to an inch thick of wood. Unfortunately, that's a focused beam. And for some reason, manufacturers don't make focusing lenses for these types of lasers for long-range use. And I'm not too sure why that is, but basically, it means our laser isn't going to be quite as powerful as the laser when it's in the CNC machine. But that being said, we're gonna be able to light a lot of stuff on fire. Now, like I was saying before, this is actually one of our most expensive projects yet. And the only reason we're even able to do projects like this is because of our generous sponsors, which is why I'm happy to introduce a sponsor for this week's video, War Robots. War Robots is an awesome tactical 6v6 multiplayer robotic warfare game. It's available for Android, iPhone, and even your computer. There's an absolutely huge variety of robots with different skills, and you can upgrade them with tons and tons of different weapons, including laser bazookas, just like ours. My favorite robot is Lancelot, which is this monstrous killing machine. The best part about the game is it's constantly being updated and it's always evolving. Plus, if you use my download link below, you'll get a GI Patton robot, Arrow Warpaint, 4 Punisher machine guns, 400,000 silver, and 100 gold to spend on whatever upgrades you want. With this offer, you'll have a pretty big advantage when you start playing. But now, back to the particle cannon. All right, let's see what this thing can do. But safety first, I'll put on my nice laser goggles. We've got some wood, some balloons, a styrofoam head. We have, I believe this is a butane-filled balloon. We have some batarangs, some normal paper, some flash paper, and of course, the Ivan head from our Red Hot Rebar crossbow video. So, let's get started. Ian, can you pull the trigger when I hold the object? She wears this aimed right now. Is it gonna hit the table? So right now, we just have the blue aiming laser on. And as you can see, it hits right about here. So we should be good to test her out. All right, paper plate. Move that a little bit. All right, go. Woo. That's hot. Ow. Shoop. And as you can see, the wood's catching on fire over here. Let's see what it does to just a piece of paper. So you can see almost instant fire. We'll just put that on the floor for safekeeping. So let's do a double whammy. This is a piece of flash paper, and this is a butane-filled balloon. Woo! That's pretty sweet. Now we've also got a batarang. We're actually gonna be sending out to a fan soon. And little they know, we're actually gonna send them two by cutting this one in half. This one's for John. I think we'll just send you a new one. How about an easy target? Now, as we mentioned in previous videos, any kind of safety glasses will actually protect you from an infrared laser, but not for very long. Hopefully long enough for you to notice there's a laser pointed at your eye and you should probably move. Fire the laser. So, as you can see, I went right up the mannequin's face and you can see his cheek is all cut into, but once it hits the safety glasses, there is no damage to the mannequin. Let's see how long it would actually take to go through these glasses though. Okay, I'm just gonna set them on the table now. And we'll put a piece of paper behind it so you can see when it pops through. Hit it. Still holding strong. You see, the beauty is when plastic starts to melt, it also starts to burn and become a charcoal, which actually can absorb even more energy and heat. So as you can see, it's okay. Now your face is on fire.
My eyes, the goggles do nothing.
That's cool. You can hear it sizzling and then it's like, whoop, and it goes all the way through. All right, let's see what happens to the Ivan head. I still got the brain matter. Why did I do that? Ew. Fire! Alright. More? Die, zombie, die! Well, we got a new eye socket. One sec, I think I used some help. Just a sprinkling of lighter fluid. Why did you light on fire at first, but now not? There we go. Whoa, look up. We should probably clean out the garage. All right, now for our final experiment, in the video game Overwatch, you can spray paint your logo on the wall in the game so other players can see it. So we thought it'd be kind of cool if we made an aperture for this so that when you burn wood, it actually burns a logo in the wood. Safety goggles back on. Power the laser up. All right, so you can see it's actually quite effective. But we've got some long-range tests coming up shortly. But first, Bogdan's gonna explain a bit about how this gun actually works. Bogdan?
So, the plasma cannon consists of two lithium polymer batteries in the back, a radiator with a fan, some Arduino components in the center, a 120-volt inverter down here, as well as a 35,000-volt DC power supply to power the 80-watt CO2 laser with a nice cooling hole at the very bottom of the gun. In the front, you see 50 meters of blue pink, and ultraviolet LEDs that create the entire glowing effect, along with a blue laser that allows you to aim the weapon. Unfortunately, as you can see, the weapon's not very wieldy, and you'd have to be a huge Russian chick to actually use it. Is that, like, I can't say that, can I? And basically, only Zarya can actually use it. So as you see, the gun looks quite cool, but in addition, it's also very functional. From about 15 feet away, you have no problem setting wood on fire, popping balloons, lighting gasoline. Wouldn't be very good against human flesh, probably burn you a little bit, but definitely not something you'd want to stand in front of. In addition, we also wear safety glasses. Just about any kind of safety glasses, polycarbonate, acrylic, glass, will stop infrared light. But just to be safe, we purchased some real safety-grade laser goggles, which I'm not currently wearing, because they're upstairs, and I don't want to get them.
I think the laser's off.
It's it. Man, I really can't see where this thing's shooting with these laser goggles.
Oh, shit!
Alright, let's try that again. Maybe I'll aim first, and then put the goggles on. That should be good. Here we go. Woo! Not bad. This is really heavy. Unfortunately, we weren't able to find a large Russian woman with pink hair to cosplay for, so we got Chris, which is the next best thing. Anyways, so Chris, let's get you loaded up with this gun.
Looks good.
So that being said, if any of you guys watching either are or know someone who cosplays as Zarya, get in touch with us because we'd love to do a short fan film with the full costume, the gun, and awesome explosions. Yes, you have to be local-ish. Ontario, New York, Detroit-ish, and be able to come here. And you have to be able to lift a 70-pound laser bazooka. But in the meantime, Chris is going to test it out for us. But wait, you need your safety glasses.
Hasta la vista, balloons.
Keep going. All right, let's see what this thing can do to some styrofoam heads. All right, let's see what happens. I see smoke. Oh, we've gone through, I think we're burning a hole in the thing behind it. Safety on. You see me? I can see you.
Are you exploding here?
All right, let's try that again. All right, Hope you guys enjoyed that project. I think it was probably one of our most ambitious Make It Real projects yet. I mean, all I wanted to do was make a laser bazooka, but Bogdan convinced us it would be way cooler to make Zarya's particle cannon, and I'm glad he did, because this has got to be one of our most aesthetic and functional Make It Real builds yet. And the only reason we're even able to do awesome projects like this is because of our generous sponsors. So if you want to help support the channel by playing an awesome game, check out War Robots. There's a link in the description below. Finally, we are planning on doing one more video with Zarya's particle cannon, and we're looking for a Zarya cosplayer to star in it. So if you know any Zarya cosplayers who are somewhat local to us and can lift a 70-pound laser bazooka, get in touch. Finally, if you're curious about how a project is going, make sure you're following us on Instagram, Facebook, or checking out our website, because we post pictures almost daily showing what we're working on the shop. And on YouTube, we can only post one video per week, and we don't post videos until the project's done. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do so, and hit that notification bell so you're notified as soon as we release the next video.